PwnedPiper threatens hospitals, Meteor Malware causes a train disruption, and BlackMatter is the new DarkSide. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse and this is ThreatWire for August 3rd, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. We have a whole bunch of new cyber attack news to get into, so on to the news. Also, if you're wondering, I'm not going to DEF CON this year. More information over on my Twitter. So if you have ever been inside a hospital, you may have seen their pneumatic tube systems, or PTS stations for short, which are used to deliver materials such as blood tests and lab samples and tissue samples, medications to wherever they are needed in medium to larger hospitals. This is considered a hospital's critical infrastructure because they allow for quick automated transport of important materials across large distances. I mean, hospitals are huge. The connected device security company Armis researched SwissLog's TransLogic pneumatic tube system and found a whole set of vulnerabilities which they have dubbed PwnedPiper. Since TransLogic PTS stations are used in more than 2,300 hospitals in North America alone, that's about 80% of hospitals, and they have 24/7 customer support from more than 3,000 worldwide, this is a serious issue. In total, Armis found 9 different issues that could allow for an unauthenticated third party to get full control of these stations across an entire hospital network. This affects current models of the TransLogic PTS stations within their Nexus Control Panel firmware. According to SwissLog, this primarily affects the North American hospitals, and they impact their HMI-3 circuit board in those control panels that are connected to the internet. SwissLog's chief privacy officer, her name is Jenny McQuaid, stated a mix of variables must exist in order for the security issues to be present. A bad actor would need access to the IT network. Now, the vulnerabilities are tracked as CVE-2021-37160 all the way up through 37167. 4 of those are memory corruption bugs that could lead to an RCE or a denial of service. Hard-coded passwords were found over Telnet. There was a privilege escalation vulnerability and a denial of service bug. That was the other 3 that I had mentioned. Now, the last one was critical. In this one, the Nexus control panel accepts unencrypted, unauthenticated firmware upgrades, so an attacker could install malicious firmware. SwissLog has been working with Armis to develop and distribute a patch and mitigation options for hospitals that are unable to patch at this time. The firmware upgrade issue is not patched yet, but they are working on it. For hospitals unable to update to the newest patches, Armis does recommend blocking Telnet port 23, deploying access control lists, and using Snort IDS rules to detect potential exploit attempts. In early July, we learned that Iran's transport ministry and national train system were hit with a cyber attack, which caused train service disruptions and the agency website to be shut down, while message boards that usually display data about trains, those were hacked, with the malicious actor showing messages that said the trains were delayed or canceled altogether due to the attack. A phone number for the office of the Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei was also included on some of those boards. Electronic tracking of trains across all of Iran failed as well during this time. Attackers locked connected Windows devices on the railway networks on a lock screen as well. Now, this attack, which happened on July 9th, was analyzed by Aman Pardaz, which is an Iranian cybersecurity firm, and Sentinel One found further information to give the public a better idea of what happened. A security researcher with Sentinel One publicized a report showing that the attack, which is called Meteor Express, used new malware called Meteor. Now, Meteor is a file wiper. It's a kind of malware used to delete files so systems are not bootable. Meteor can wipe a system, lock the master boot record, and install screen lockers as well. It's quite destructive, and they aren't used for ransom profits. Malicious actors who use file wipers are in it for the lulz, or to cause stress or dumpster fires for the companies targeted. They can also be used as a distraction technique for additional campaigns. Sentinel-1 explains that a RAR archive protected with a password is extracted by the attacker, and the associated files are added to a network share that's accessible to the railway network. Windows group policies are reconfigured so the attacker can launch a setup.bat, which is a batch file, which copies executables and other batch files to the local devices, then runs or executes them to check for antivirus and terminate the attack if Kaspersky AV is flagged. They disconnect the device, they can add Windows Defender exclusions for the malware, clear event logs, delete a diagnostics task, they even flush the file system cache to disk, and they launch the wiper and the lockers. Now, all of that makes the infected device unbootable and it wipes it of all of its files. Now, interestingly, Sentinel-1 points out that Meteor attacks the same sectors as NotPetya, but this was also used in the original Petya campaigns, and it was widely used. So we don't know at this time who is behind the railway attacks or if the motive was just to cause chaos. The researchers included indication rules for fellow security researchers in the event that this new malware is more widely used. Big shout out to my Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sharing their adorable fur baby photos and for the support every single week. And a quick shout out to Retro for joining the ThreatWire Alliance and as always for supporting the show. Thank you so much for joining. Check out the Patreon Alliance for your exclusive access to an audio only podcast version of the show. And now onto the third news story. Well, we speculated a bit in a previous episode about what happened to DarkSide. Well, now we know. So DarkSide is rebranding like a canceled YouTuber to now be called BlackMatter, and they are already working on new attacks. So to refresh your memory, DarkSide was behind the attack on the US Colonial Pipeline, which caused a real big shutdown and fuel shortages on the East Coast. DarkSide found themselves in hot water in international law enforcement crosshairs. They disappeared, lost access to their servers, and they had a bunch of their Bitcoin seized by the FBI. Yeah, I did a bunch of coverage on this in a previous episode, so check out the YouTube channel for that video. Well, Bleeping Computer has been following reports from Black Matter victims already and found ransoms range from $3 to $4 million with one victim already paying. Interestingly, Black Matter states on their public sites that they won't target hospitals, critical infrastructure facilities, oil and gas industries, the defense industry, nonprofits, and the government sector. While Fabian Wosar, a ransomware expert, received a decryptor tool from Bleeping Computer, who received it from a Black Matter victim, and he analyzed this tool to find it used the same encryption methods that DarkSide used. In fact, he stated on Twitter, it's pretty much an exact copy. That goes for both their RSA and their Salsa 20 implementation and their use of a custom matrix. They also use very similar language and public theming around their personas. Very interesting. We're going to follow it in the future in case Black Matter does attack any very big companies or organizations. Hey, if you're into Sailor Moon, I know this is totally random, and you want to see me do some anime otaku reviews, subscribe to my YouTube anime channel. It's youtube.com/sailorsnubs. And with that, do not forget to like and subscribe to this channel as well. We are on our way to the next big, big milestone, whatever that might be. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.